Hello guys, this is Abir. Welcome to my channel, Abir in the Kitchen. I'm gonna show you some quick and easy recipes, so stay tuned. Guys, guess what? It's a biryani time. So let's start the biryani and we'll show you how to do it in a good way. So guys, for the biryani we are using here, chicken is a thigh with the bones in. The spices we are going to use, salt, some garam masala, chilli powder, cumin powder, coriander powder, some bay leaves, cardamom, and some black pepper whole, turmeric, and here is yogurt and ginger garlic paste. So for the ginger garlic paste, it's just like a 50-50%, half ginger and half garlic. So marinating our chicken thighs with a yogurt. So the yogurt we are using around like 150 gram of yogurt. The chicken we have around like 1.5 kg. Ginger garlic paste. After that we are going to put our spices, salt to taste, garam masala, chili powder, coriander powder, some cumin powder, turmeric powder, cumin powder, some whole spices we are using here, green cardamom, cloves, black pepper, I already mentioned you everything. So marination of the chicken is done. We're gonna leave our chicken for 30 minutes so like the marination goes inside the meat and release more flavors, and 30 minutes is more than enough. So the water is ready, we are going to parboil our rice. Just make sure guys, like we are cooking our rice, not 100%. We're gonna take out our rice until like 65 to 75% done. So guys, our rice is done. It's time to strain our rice. So now we are ready to cook our biryani. So this is our marinated chicken that I just showed you how to marinate it. Clarified butter, this is a saffron like we soaked it up in lukewarm water, cilantro, mint, brown onions, green chilies, and a rice. So the pan is hot, or a pot. Starting with the clarified butter. Adding on marinated chicken into our clarified butter or a ghee. Desi ghee basically. I know like all my Indian friends, they know what is desi ghee means. So guys, to make a biryani, literally you don't need anything. It's just you think a good marination on the chicken, couple of spices, and that's it. So we're gonna cook our chicken also like a 50% pretty much. So like after that, the main cooking will be happening on a dum. For the dum, I will gonna explain you later on what is dum. So just bear with me, just be with me. And let's the cooking begins. Yeah, look at that. Chicken already has a very beautiful color on it because of the marination. But guys, believe me, like once the saffron will go in, this will gonna change the whole play. So to check out that result, you have to stay with us. So stay with us. Guys, the smell is amazing. Guys, Guys, so we are in the middle of our biryani, which is going to start now on a dum cook. So for the dum cooking, we have to layer our other products. So there is a chicken, the first layer. After that, we are going to add on some chopped cilantro, and after that, chopped mint leaves or pudina, whatever would you like to say. Green chilies. Green chilies just slit into half. Guys, if you want little less heat or less spicy, you can just use the level of red chili powders and a green chili. After that, the rice which I showed you earlier, that is cooked around like 65-70%. It is not 100% cooked because we just leave it a little bit raw purposely, so like we can finish it later on with a dum cook. Another layer of cilantro, another layer of mint leaves. Here you go. Now we'll go some brown onion as well on it. The brown onion is basically a kind of like game changer for the biryani. For that, you must have nice crispy brown onions. Just make sure like it is not getting burned. So here you go, all the rice goes in now. Steam on the lens. Here you go guys, so just level it nice. So like you're just making sure that all the steam, how much you want to capture the steam inside the pot, we have to do that. So that is something around like dum cooking. But if you go old traditional style dum cooking, they use like charcoal to cover it top everywhere, but we are in home, right? So we really cannot do that. So here you go, the saffron which was soaked in a lukewarm water is gonna give a like nice color to our biryani, and that I'm gonna show you why in the later on. We're gonna put rest of all other condiments, this leftover all mint and cilantro and brown onions. Use everything, no wastage. So everything is on the pot. Now we are going to wait on a high heat for 3 to 4 minutes to make sure our sauce is on right on the boiling point, because like you just, then you just add on rice on it, right? Rice getting a little colder, so we need to that temperature has to be back again. So wait for another 2-3 minutes, and after that we're gonna just slow down our heat to a very low, and that is how it's all done. So like just want to capture all the steam inside. So it's already 3 to 4 minutes. We are going to reduce our heat. To the very low. And we're gonna wait for 30 minutes. In 30 minutes, our biryani is going to be ready. So guys, it's all about the waiting time. So I'm gonna show you. Going to start the timer. And setting my timer on 30 minutes. Yay. Timer is set 30 minutes, and exactly 30 minutes need for our biryani to be done. Another 5 minutes for the biryani. Guys, just wait 5 more minutes and our wonderful, delicious, yummy, tasty biryani will be ready. So guys, it's 000, time to turn off the biryani. So, turning off. So our biryani is done. Oh, look at that. Guys, like just give a rest. Leave the lid open. and wait for 5 minutes. Don't just start mix up right away, otherwise you can really mash, you can break your rice, that we really don't want it. So yeah, just leave it 5 minutes, and after 5 minutes we can start mix our biryani together. So we already waited for 5 minutes, now we are going to mix our biryani. It looks very good. You know why I was picking you like to add saffron? You see, like, if I take a more close-up, let me make it more clear. You see, like, three, four different kind of colors. Like saffron, yellow color is came out from the marination of the chicken, and the white, the rice was white itself. So that's our biryani look like. Let's taste some biryani and find out how is the taste. It is delicious. So this is our biryani, garnished with some freshly chopped cilantro. You can garnish more things over there, like fried red chilies, more brown onions. Guys, I just want to show you like why this is very important. Why this is very important, look. So like this is biryani over here. This is done already beautifully. Guys, so the beauty of the biryani. Why the biryani? Look at the rice. Everything is single piece. Yeah, that's you.
I can't find my
clothes. Just a second, just. So like, look at here. Look at here, the rice. Everything is single pieces. Cooked so beautifully. Rice is done. Right, so just use this recipe and make the biryani in your home in an easy way. So for more amazing video like this, more amazing recipes, don't forget to subscribe my channel. See you next time. Have fun. Bye-bye, cheers. So more interesting videos like this, please subscribe my channel and don't forget to press the bell icon for the future notification. And also, please hit the like button and also do share. Thank you very much. See you next time. Bye-bye.